Greetings world. We are anonymous. We do not forgive, we do not forget. Expect us. An Alberta man who feared he was a risk to himself and his family resorted to posting a public plea for mental health care on Facebook after he was sent away from multiple hospitals over the course of a month. They were basically saying you're not sick enough, said the man of the Frog Lake First Nation. I think that's where the gap is, from people who are healthy to severely mentally ill, then there are people who are in between. Now he is certified under the Mental Health Act and admitted to the Centennial Center for Mental Health and Brain Injury in Pinoca, Alberta, Canada, but he worries that other people grappling with suicidal thoughts will experience the same gaps in the system that he did, and he doesn't want them to fall through the cracks. Alberta Health Services Executive Director of Addictions and Mental Health in Edmonton said too many beds are being occupied by people who are well enough to be released, according to a report he received on Tuesday, June 26. All 613 of the beds reserved for mental health patients in the city's hospitals were full, however 28% of them were filled by people who could be discharged if there were sufficient community supports in place. We, as a system, have an accountability to make sure that if the hospital bed is not the most appropriate place for them, to provide that warm and supportive handoff to something else. We need to do it in a way that's going to get people connected to services and not feel like they've been left abandoned or unsupported. That's obviously something we, as a system, need to do better. The Alberta man said he doesn't have a history of diagnosed mental health issues, began on May 3 when he found himself with sky-high blood pressure, unable to eat or sleep. He checked himself into the University of Alberta Hospital, where he was certified and transferred to Alberta Hospital for about a week and then released. He relapsed and checked himself into the Centennial Center but without being certified, was able to leave on his own when he felt better. Once again he relapsed. After that he said he visited hospitals in Calgary, Red Deer, and Edmonton where he was assessed and then sent home with medication. Desperate and teary-eyed, he posted a video on Facebook on June 16 describing his struggle to get help. It's been viewed about 230,000 times and shared more than 5,500 times. One of the people who saw his plea was Edmonton-based Indigenous filmmaker Georgina Lightning, who has complex post-traumatic stress disorder. It hit me hard, Lightning said. I was like, here's a guy who's struggling and he's being rejected from the system. Lightning said she remembered how challenging it was to get mental health help when she needed it back in 2012. Everywhere I went, there were no resources, there was no help, nobody knew how to help. Lightning eventually connected with Calgary-based family physician Tracy Thompson, who also runs a private clinic in Kenmore that specializes in a technique called brain mapping. The neuroscience techniques can provide insights into mental health issues and guide treatment. Thompson said about 80% of her patients struggle with mental health issues and many are grappling with the gap in the system that the man identified. The Alberta government has studied this gap, releasing a report last year called Valuing Mental Health. It focuses heavily on the fragmentation in the system and the need to develop the community-based supports that was referred to when discussing how to free up hospital beds. We must make it easier for people to access and move through the system, stated the report, accompanied by a 3-year action plan. The report also notes the additional barriers facing diverse populations, including Indigenous peoples. It's a fact that our First Nations people in Alberta, there is a health inequity there and they do have worse health outcomes, and a significant barrier to them accessing health care is trust. There's been decades of institutional racism and stereotyping that have worsened that trust. Improving health and mental health care for Indigenous peoples is a priority for Alberta Health Services. When someone is open to accepting mental health help, providers need to respond within the window of opportunity. Many Indigenous peoples face what is called the double jeopardy of living in isolated areas and struggling with historical trauma. Not only can they not access mainstream mental health in any significant way that would help them, even if they do, they're probably not getting services that understand their historic trauma needs. We are anonymous. We do not forgive, we do not forget. Expect us.